Everybody want to do, come on here. Everybody want to do, but nobody wants to be the child.
Right.
My grandmother used to say all the time, there's so many Indians and not enough Jesus.
That's right.
Too many Jews, that's not the law.
That's right.
Too many Jews and not enough Indian. Children to the side.
Uh-huh.
You turn old folks to, I ain't got time. The Bible just says when you, oh, help me, Holy Ghost of God, and who's going to receive such child in my name, receives me. So somebody going to hell for rejecting Christ. Let them children sit down. They don't know what they're doing. You got the children out dancing. They don't even know that they're dancing, for you don't know what you're dancing for neither. The music sound good. It's a sad thing to tell these babies that God is real and go home and act like he did. It's a sad thing to tell them you ought to call on God, and we come in church like we did tonight, and the power of God trying to show up and you sit down on him. What you teaching the kid? Oh, God must not be real. Oh, God only come, you know, we can glorify him and be our bank, money in the bank. We can pay the real bill when we got something. We don't realize the message that we putting out to our children. Because when you get a real good praise, it's when everything is going good. Any good delivery service, I'm going to tell you the truth, 90% of that good delivery service comes from folks that is going through and they only want to come out. So good. They cry because they want to come out whatever it is that they
eat.
That's the truth. That's the truth. Jesus. Absolutely. Woo! Woo! The teacher. That's the truth. But who's going to cause one of these children, these little ones, who believes in me to stumble? It is better for him that a heavy millstone is hung around his neck. Grace ain't said this. The Lord said, when you start messing with my children, you might as well kill yourself. See, your enemies don't even realize what they're doing. Don't let them keep like they don't talk to you. They can come up against ministry, your family, your head, and everything that you do, but you just let them keep right on talking. Because what you don't understand is, when you be obedient unto God, you present yourself as a child to him. What he's supposed to be, I bet. When a daddy got a good child, they don't try to run around the daddy. They always, yes, sir. Yeah, daddy, I do whatever you want me to do. They humble. And the Lord said, if you present yourself to be humble, stop. I'm not saying you can't question him, but I'm saying every time he tells you something, you gotta question. You know what I can't stand? I can't stand to tell my kid, ask my kid something, and they turn around and rephrase the question and still ask me what I just asked him. We ain't getting nowhere. Because what I need is an action. So he said, it is better for him than hang the head.
The Lord said, don't get that life. Do it. If you're going to do it, you're going to do it.
order. He said, you're going all the way. Might as well go ahead. Ain't no sense in playing Russian roulette. You know where the bully is. Go ahead. I'm trying to help the children. Is that all right?
All right.
If you line yourself a child of God, then you line. You where I'm talking about.
Uh-huh.
I got one more scripture. Very short. I'm going to read it. It's Matthew the 19th chapter, the 13th verse.
Uh-huh.
Then some children were brought to him.
Yes.
Children was brought to him so that he might lay his hands on them and pray.
Uh-huh.
And their disciples. I'm so sick of church folk, I don't know what to do. No doubt this was some sinners that was looking for an action that brought their babies and said, touch them all, pray for them. And it was the church. The disciples repelled them. Ain't nothing worse than having a group of folk that can't get with you. They follow you everywhere, but they yet a hindrance. Best to be helping ministry and they killing ministry. Best to be getting souls and destroying lives. It's the church. It's the church. Rebuke them. And Jesus said, let the children alone. Somebody got to speak. Somebody got to stand up and get a backbone. How can I shout?
Chaplain us, and we not only killing him, we said, Lord, that house we died.
You know, I could have had a good time today, but you know that Pastor Roberts, I tell you, every time she get up and all that hollering, I mean, I'm just trying to say, you know, service would have been real good, except, you know, I'm just saying, if she would get up there on that show, what thing I could wear that shiny suit for? She wants to be a man. You ain't even heard of not a bad old man the preacher said. Except the preacher said, get saved when you study going on the hill, I wrap the mirrors.
Indeed you can. Give us
some tea. The word says.
Give us some tea.
It says, if any man be in Christ.
Yeah.
He is a new creature. Y'all better follow me because I'm getting ready to go somewhere real deep.
All right, take your time.
If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature.
Yeah.
The only way a creature can go extinct is if they stop breathing. And the church that the Lord is setting up is no longer.
What you say?
Hey. The children of God, we didn't like Michael Jackson, but he was trying to save the world. It's a sad thing, the sinners got vision and the church ain't got See, it's the world that is together. Oh, Jesus, help us. It's the church that is suffering because he said, it's my people. I say this all the time, a lot of times people don't understand what I'm saying. I'm not trying to give nobody a reason to drink or go drink, but I want you to understand what I'm getting ready to say. I believe it was a particular party, I believe it was a wedding celebration that Jesus himself
His first miracle. Now get out of here.
That's somebody that recognizes that in the church. The church has said,